Good morning. Welcome to Bible Practice. Today's inspiration is another good one, of course. I love them all. Here's, if you want to go to the Bible, you can go to 1 Peter 5, verse 6 through 7, Psalm 62, verse 8, and 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 18. And those are the Bible passages that inspired these words. The words are this: thank me in the midst of the crucible. Okay? You think about that line. Crucible is the world. Okay? He wants us to thank him in the midst of it. Okay? When things seem all wrong, look for growth opportunities. When things are wrong in your life, we don't do that. We should look for growth opportunities. Because those circumstances have been put in our life for us to grow, for us to become closer to Jesus. But that's hard for people to see. They look at it as punishment or bad luck or whatever they want to look at. But it's not. It comes from God. And it's to help you. Very difficult for mortals to see. Especially look for areas where you need to let go, leaving your cares in my able hands. It's a good one, huh? Kind of happening in my life right now in a couple of situations that I'm in. And I'm seeing that. I'm learning that this is the truth. This is what we need to do. We need to let go of our cares. Do you trust me to orchestrate your life events as I choose? Or are you still trying to make things go according to your will? Praise God and thank you, Jesus. That is so true. We are doing it. I'm doing it. You're doing it. Not in everything, maybe. We're trying to follow Jesus closer, but we're still trying to orchestrate our own life. We got to stop doing it. Praise God, huh? The truth is so clear, and yet, people don't see it. If you keep trying to carry out your intentions while I am leading you in another direction, you defy your desires. Praise God. Be on the lookout for what I am doing in your life. Worship me by living close to me, thanking me in all circumstances. And again, 1 Peter 5, verses 6 through 7, Psalm 62, verse 8, and 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 18. Praise God. You know, to thank him in all circumstances, it's a tough one. But we have to do that. He tells us to do it. The Bible tells us to do it. I don't think man would tell you to do that, because man is more self-centered. We think that we have to make our lives perfect and everything should run exactly smoothly. But if you read the Bible and just think about Jesus' life, his life did not go smoothly in every circumstance. So why do we expect ours to? We think just because we believe in Jesus that our life is going to go perfect. Not here, folks. It's not going to happen here. It only happens in heaven. And the only way into heaven is through him. You can deny it. You can not believe it. You can do whatever you want to do with it. But the truth is the truth. It's the only way you're going to get there. You don't want to go there? No. He'll feel bad for you. But he's not going to stop you if you choose not to. You have to make the choice to do it. Think of the Garden of Eden. That's where it all started. Man and woman at that point in time decided to do it their way. And God gave us Jesus to get back to him. Because he loves us that much. He didn't have to do that. And think about it. Just let us all sit out here and rot. Go down. Well, I got to keep singing. And I know there's others out there saying, I mean, wish Pat, I know Pat had some surgery yesterday. We wish her well. And I know the surgery had to have gone well because I asked Jesus to be in a surgeon's hands, and I'm sure the others prayed for her. And whatever the results were, that's what God wanted it to be. So, and I'll find out what happened here in the next few days, and I'll let you know. But we love you, Pat. Everybody, keep Pat on your mind. Keep bringing you closeness with Jesus. Huh? All right, have a great day. I'll be back tomorrow. If God wills, peace. Love you.